In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create an application with AppSheet and automate actions within it with AppScript. Hi, I'm Chanel, a developer advocate at Google. I invite you to follow along as I work through this video. The only thing you will need is a Google Workspace account. Prepare the data. For this tutorial, our data source is a project tracker in the form of a Google Sheets file. We have one sheet containing all of the relevant information. For us humans, that is the best way to get the full picture. But for AppSheet to understand our data, we will normalize it. What does that mean? Database normalization is a technique used in software development to do away with data redundancy and optimize data structure. The first step in normalizing data is to spread it out into separate tables. In Google Sheets, the equivalent of that is to spread out our data into different sheets. So now we have three separate tables, sometimes also referred to as entities: tasks, projects, and managers. Note how the task sheet contains a reference to the project sheet in the last column. The projects sheet contains a reference to the tasks sheet and the managers sheet. And lastly, the manager's sheet contains a reference to the project's sheet. Note that the profile photos URLs in the last column lead to the images themselves and not to the file hosted on Google Drive. Here, an illustration of the normalized data structure. To get the most out of AppSheet, it helps to organize the data in such an app-friendly way. By the way, I highly recommend you subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Create the app. Now it's time to create our app. We do so directly from within Google Sheets by choosing AppSheet from the Extensions menu. While AppSheet is creating the app for us, let's have a look at the project's shared drive. For every project listed in the project tracker, there is a dedicated folder. Instead of having to add this folder manually whenever a new project is added to the project tracker, we want to automate this. For that, we will have AppSheet call our AppScript function. In the meantime, AppSheet has created an app based on our data. We see in the app preview that a tasks and a statistics view have been created. Customize app. AppSheet has created an app based on our data. Now it's time to customize the app according to our needs. We start off by adding the projects table to our app. Next, we add our managers table to the app. Let's have a look at the columns of the managers table. Note how the managers table doesn't reference the projects table. If we look at the tasks table, we see that projects are of data type text. That means there is no actual reference to the projects table. Let's add these references and we'll start with changing the data type for the project column on the task table from text to ref. We choose projects as the source table for this reference. On the projects table, we repeat this action. Now the managers column is a reference to the managers table. The last step is to create a reference between the manager's table and the project's table. For this, we regenerate the data structure. Now, the references between the tables have been established. Next, we want to define what information the users of our apps will see. This we do in the Apps section. Let's start by creating a new view, which we'll call Projects, and we'll display the data from the corresponding table. We'll change the view type to table and have the button for this view displayed in the middle. There are a large number of icons we can choose from. For the projects view, we'll use a computer as our button. Don't forget to save your changes from time to time. Every time you do so, the preview app will reload to reflect the changes you've made. Let's edit the task view, which is one of the default views that was created by AppSheet. Note that AppSheet automatically added sorting and grouping to this view. We can choose to change this according to our needs. For this tutorial, though, the default sorting and grouping is just as we need. For the statistics view, we want to change the displayed data from tasks to projects and have the button for the view in the first position. We want the chart to be a pie chart, and visualize the data from the budget column. We've done quite some customizing so far. Let's have a look at our app to see the progress. Let's switch to the tablet view and then to projects. When we click on one of the projects, we are brought to a detailed view. Note how we see data from our projects table and the associated tasks. A click on the name of the manager brings us to the details for that manager. Immediately, we see that the photo of the manager isn't showing. Instead, we see the URL of the photo. Let's fix that. We do so by changing the data type for the photo column in the manager's table from URL to image. Once we save the change, the preview app reloads and we now see a profile photo. From this view, we can scroll through to the other manager's details. I think it would make sense to add a dedicated manager's view. In the app section, we add the manager's view and select the gallery view type. Clicking on one of the managers brings us to the detailed view. From here, we can access the projects associated with that manager. Add app script. To automate the creation of a folder for every new project, we are going to write a short app script function. We need to create a standalone script and we'll save it directly in our project's shared drive. We'll rename the script to easily identify it when we add it to our app in AppSheet. We enable the drive API since this enables us to create a folder in a shared drive. We name our function createNewFolder and define it to use a parameter which we name project. We define a variable that will contain the ID of the automatically created folder. To create the folder, we use the drive API which we previously enabled. To insert a new file in a shared drive, we have to add the ID of the parent folder. This ID we copy directly from the project's shared drive URL and paste it into the function we are writing. The property title is the actual name of the folder we want to automatically create. We define that the name will be provided by the project parameter that is passed into the function when executed. The MIME type property defines that it is a folder we want to create. The null is because we don't have any file content to pass into the insert method. Since we are creating a folder on a shared drive, supports all drives is set to true. We chain the ID property to the insert method to be able to store the ID of the automatically created folder. The return value of the function is the URL of the automatically created folder. We are using template literals to add the ID of the folder to the URL. Template literals require backticks and not quotation marks. When this function runs, it will create a new folder in the project shared drive and return the URL of that folder to our AppSheet app. Now it's time to connect our AppSheet app with our AppScript function. To achieve this, we access the bot section in AppSheet and add a new custom bot. We now have to define the event that triggers this bot to run. The event type is when data is added, and we call the event project is added. We define that data changes on the projects table trigger this event. Next, we define the process that this event will run. We call this process or step createFolder. We define that this step calls the createNewFolder script that we created previously. We then authorize the AppScript project to run. We choose the createNewFolder function, which expects a parameter to be passed in. We use the expression assistant to choose the name column from the projects table to be the project parameter for the function. Lastly, we define that the AppScript function will return a value of type string. We want AppSheet to convert this string to the AppSheet type of URL. We add the final step and call it AppFolderToApp. This step will add the folder URL returned by the AppScript function to the folder column. We use the expression assistant to write the new value, createFolder.output. As we can see, the test of this expression was successful. Those were all the necessary steps to connect our AppSheet app to our AppScript project. Test app. Now it's time to test our app. Please note that any Google Workspace user can perform this test. If you want to deploy this app to your team, though, you will need an AppSheet license. Let's add a new project to our app. But wait, there's a problem. Can you spot it? The folder URL is a required input. Obviously, that's not what we want, since the folder column will receive its value from the bot we just created. To fix that, we untick the require box for the folder column on the projects table. Okay, now we're ready for the next round of testing. We add our data to the app and sync it. Let's have a look at our new project entry. We see that the folder contains a URL. By clicking on it, we verify that our AppScript function successfully created a new folder for our project. If you want to access the code for the AppScript project, then follow the link in the description below. Hit that like button if you've learned something new in this video. And subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos about Google Workspace development and AppSheet.